Could someone list your house for sale even if you're not really selling your home? Well, that's what happened to a Dearborn Heights homeowner.
He'd never met the realtor. He'd never heard of the church ministry that was now claiming to hold a deed to his house. Rob Wolchek says this is more than just a mix-up. He joins us with a problem solver investigation.
Hello, Monica. The house was sold in something called a portfolio. Some say these bulk sales are destroying neighborhoods because it kind of takes the people out of the equation. In this case, the bulk sellers traded the house back and forth, even though it was apparently owned by the family living in it since 2011. Block after block of rundown houses. How did I end up here in Detroit with a feeling of doom that these neighborhoods will never come back? This was supposed to be a story about a guy and some people he thought were shaking him down. But I may have stumbled upon a bigger problem. Something called bulk portfolio real estate. And it's got everything to do with riches and ruin. This is Kevin. This is Kevin's house. This is Kevin's house for sale. The problem is, Kevin's not selling his house.
It didn't make sense.
Kevin's got a warranty deed to the house. That means he owns it free and clear, right? Kevin or someone in his family's lived in the home since 2011.
So imagine Kevin's surprise when a few months ago, strangers started showing up at his house, looking in the windows, taking pictures of his house. When Kevin confronted the looky-loos, they told him, well, the house is for sale.
We went to Google, we looked it up, we found out it was listed by Wendy Briggs.
Who's Wendy Briggs? Well, she's a real estate broker, and she's also a bulk portfolio home buyer. What's that mean?
It's like going to one of those warehouse stores and buying a ton of paper towels because they're super cheap if you buy them in bulk. Except instead of paper towels, she's buying houses.
How many homes does Wendy Briggs have? According to this map I got from the University of Michigan Dearborn, a ton. Each one of these dots represents a house. So how'd Kevin's Dearborn Heights house end up in Wendy Briggs' Detroit portfolio? He's never even heard of her. Kevin calls her.
Wendy, I says, what needs to be done for this to go away? How do we fix this? She says, somebody's got to give Comeback Home Ministries $15,000.
Who's Comeback Home Ministries? They're another group involved in bulk portfolio home buying. Kevin's never heard of them either. Kevin's praying for help, so he calls the problem solvers. We do some digging and discover, yes indeed, Kevin has a warranty deed to his house, but there are other deeds to the house floating around out there. Quitclaim deeds, which are basically quickie deeds that make it easy to move a house from one party to another. Turns out Wendy got the house quitclaim deeded to her company Trading Places in a bulk home portfolio transaction, along with more than 100 other homes in 2013.
She buys it for $3,000, right? Never even shows up. She takes and turns around and quitclaim deeds it to Comeback Home Ministries for $1. And then Comeback Home Ministry takes that and he sells the property for $8,500 to this other guy.
The other guy? This guy, Franz John Ivezi. You guessed it, he's another bulk portfolio home dude. Franz then quit claims the house for $1 back to Comeback Home Ministries. What the heck is going on? I'm gonna talk to Franz.
Listen, my friend, I bought a house and it was fun to me.
Wendy.
I bit off way more than I could chew.
The pastor from Comeback Home Ministries.
It's no scheme.
And the guy who somehow started this whole mess in a minute. But first, this is Dr. Joshua Akers from the University of Michigan Dearborn. He's behind a research project called Urban Praxis. They out bulk property owners. He thinks portfolio buying is contributing to the decay of neighborhoods. Houses that were once owned by families are now commodities. They're not homes, they're things. Things sold in bulk. Here's how a bulk portfolio business person works.
I get a bunch of investors together. I have a portfolio of 150 properties. The condition of all of those properties don't really matter. What I'm going to sell to you as an investor is the idea that you're going to get 20% returns. So the impetus is on me to find a way in which to produce those returns.
The buyers take a gamble that some of the properties are salvageable. Some of them aren't, but that doesn't matter. They're dealing in bulk.
Or you just leave that in there to keep the number of properties in your portfolio looking robust.
So who are these bulk portfolio home traders? Top-notch real estate whizzes? Upstanding citizens looking to better the neighborhoods? Let's examine the bulk portfolio people involved with Kevin's house. First off, there's Douglas Diggs. He was appointed as a receiver by the court to clean up a mess involving homes bought in a giant scheme called the Paramount case involving the Detroit Police and Fire Pension Fund.
The problem is, Kevin's house doesn't appear to be a part of that case. But there's Digg's signature quit claiming Kevin's house to Wendy's company. I asked Douglas Diggs if he was to blame for Kevin's house seeming to get plucked out of nowhere and into a bulk sale he oversaw. Whose fault is it? Is it your fault? He replied, "Yeah, I'm sorry. I don't take responsibility for it. It was part of a portfolio." A portfolio. A whole bunch of houses. Here's what the spokesperson for the pension fund has to say about that. Whether this was an error or willful misconduct to convey a title one did not own is something that the authorities may wish to review. Diggs told me he'd have his attorney call. We didn't get the call, and unfortunately, Mr. Diggs died shortly after we interviewed him. Next on the mysterious quitclaim chain, Wendy Briggs.
I bought many, many homes from the Third Circuit Court-appointed Douglas Diggs.
Right.
I sold several of those homes to Come Back Home Ministries, a church.
Wendy admits she'd never been to this church, but she quitclaimed the house to the church. Its reverend is a convicted felon named Sylvester Seal Murray.
But why do you give it to Sylvester Murray and Come Back Home Ministries for a dollar?
He wanted 32 of the home. No, he paid me.
So how much did he buy it for?
$6,000.
Let's see what the reverend has to say.
Tell me about the ministry. Is this a ministry or is this just a money-making scheme? What is it?
No, don't talk about this scheme. This is real.
Yeah, it's real. Real shady. Murray the minister has a past that's sinister. He was a big shot in a heroin ring called Young Boys, Inc. If anyone's soul needs saving, it's Sylvester Murray's. And if anyone needs some non-taxable money, it's Sylvester Murray. According to his 2011 bankruptcy, he owes the IRS $14 million.
I'm spending, but I'm not making any money.
Because you filed for bankruptcy, you got $14 million in...
That's a person with me. They got nothing to do with Come Back Home Ministry.
I hate to doubt a man of the cloth, but I can't even find this place. They're not on the directory in the office they claim to rent. There's no one at either of their addresses. I caught the Come Back Home Minister coming back out of the Maple View Liquor Store in West Bloomfield. So where's the congregation meet, Rev?
Church is on 15167, okay, James Cousin. That's where the church is at, off Pierton.
You have a church?
Yes.
Nice try. That address is this vacant lot. Next, I meet up with Franz Avijai. A warning, this guy's kind of camera shy. Might be because he's a registered sex offender.
I need to find out about this quitclaim deed that you did with this house from Come Back Home Ministries. You bought this house for $8,000. And then you quitclaimed it back to Come Back Home Ministries. Okay. This guy's having a lot of problems with his house. Can you fill me in on what this is all about?
I bought a house and it was not good. I didn't want the deal. It was messed up title and that was it.
So this guy at least checked the title on the house and realized it belonged to Kevin years ago. So why is Wendy Briggs listing Kevin's house now? She blames it on Sylvester Murray and Come Back Home Ministries.
So did Murray contact you earlier this year and say, hey, sell this house on Monroe?
Yes, he did.
But he acts like this is news to him.
So now she put the house up for sale. Briggs did.
When was this?
Like this year.
Okay.
For Wendy Briggs and Sylvester Murray, Kevin's house wasn't his home. It was just another thing. A thing to be traded. Wendy's now taking the house off her website. Nobody's contacted Kevin in months. Maybe they realized this thing wasn't going to make them money. Which leads us back to Professor Akers and why he thinks bulk portfolio sales are so destructive. Remember, many of the houses in Detroit were purchased in bulk. And he says when the buyers can't make money off them, they bail.
When you can't convince someone to take the home anymore, what do? They walk away. It goes to tax foreclosure auction. It goes all the way through. It goes to the land bank and the public's on the hook for paying the bill.
And ultimately, it destroys the city and the neighborhoods.
Yeah. Piece by piece.
Now, Kevin says he's spoken to investigators from the Wayne County Deed Fraud Task Force. He also says he's reported Wendy Briggs to the State Board of Realtors. Wendy told me over the phone, quote, "This has been a complete nightmare. She says she's done nothing wrong and everything legally." Wendy says she's cooperating with investigators. She no longer has a relationship with Come Back Home Ministries or Sylvester Murray. Murray never returned my calls.